Yeah, this is a joint paper with Markus Ulbricht. My name is Ringo Baumann, and the title of the talk is Choices and Their Consequences, Explaining Acceptable Sets in Abstract Argumentation Frameworks. Well, as you all know, explainability is currently one of the current key challenges in AI. For instance, in the German AI strategy, you can read, making AI explainable, accountable, and transparent is the key to winning over the public's trust. And there are, however, a larger number of applications where the technology is still a black box. This especially applies to non-symbolic approaches like neural networks, but there are also problems with explanations in symbolic approaches. And yeah, explainability is not only a nice add-on, it is by now a legal requirement in the General Data Protection Regulation from 2018. You can read, so this regulation establishes a right for all individuals to obtain meaningful explanations of the logic involved when automated decision-making takes place. And the logical formalism we are considering here are abstract argumentation frameworks, and more precisely, we are dealing with the question of how to explain the outcome of an argumentation semantics. So very briefly, so what is an argumentation semantics? You can see here the definition. So this is just a total function which takes as an input a so-called argumentation framework, which is just a directed graph, where the nodes are interpreted as arguments and the edges, and the edges between them are interpreted as attacks. And the outcome is a set of sets of arguments, so-called extensions. And these extensions can be seen somehow as reasonable positions, as sets which are strong enough to withstand the other arguments given the current argumentation scenario. So let's have an example. So we see here a directed graph, an argumentation framework containing eight arguments and A, B, C, D, one, and so on. And A attacks C, B attacks C, C attacks D, one, and so on. One very prominent semantics, so-called complete semantics, and it returns complete extensions. And here on the right-hand side, you see the output, three complete extensions, A, B, A, B, D, one, F, A, B, D, two. And the question is, how are these complete extensions defined, and they are given as one characterization, conflict-free fixed points of the characteristic function. And yeah, what is the characteristic function? This is a total function. You see here the definition. It takes as an input a set of arguments, and it returns all arguments which are defended by this set. Yeah? And defense means all attackers of an argument are counterattacked. And you can show that this function is monotonic, and then you know by Knast-Ratajski that there are fixed points. You can iterate over the empty set, and iterating over the empty set always yields conflict-free sets. And in this way, you can show that there are conflict-free fixed points. And let's check here in the example for A, B, D1, F that it is a complete extension. So this means we have to check conflict-freeness, that it is a prefix point as well as a postfix point. So conflict freeness is clear. There are no attacks between A and B, A and D and one, and so on. This is very simple to check. Then the prefix point, here we have to check whether E, all arguments in E are defended by E. So AB is defended by E because E counterattacks all attackers of AB because there are no attackers of A and B. D1 is defended by E because C attacks D1. This is counterattacked by an argument colored in cyan, namely by A, for instance. And D1 is also attacked by D2, but this is counterattacked by D1. Well, and the same for F. And in the next step, we have to check that it is a postfix point. So here it suffices to check that for any argument which is not in E, it is also not defended by E. So for instance, C is not in E. C is attacked by A, but A is not counterattacked by an argument colored in cyan, so C is not defended. D2 is not in E, D2 is attacked by C, but this is a counter attack by A, but D2 is also attacked by D1, and this is not counter attack by an argument colored in cyan. So in this way, we can check that it is a conflict-free fixed point. And of course, the question is this easy to understand for non-experts? Yeah, if somebody asks, so why F is acceptable, and you say, okay, because F is part of a conflict-free fixed point of the characteristic function. And in this paper, we have shown that complete extensions can be understood as accepting the indisputable plus choices. And by choices, we mean selecting arguments from even cycles. And the inspiration to this work traces back to Dunn and Bench Capone, as well as Dvorak, as because they have shown that different complete extensions are due to the existence of even cycles. So what is indisputable here? Well, even in a very skeptical view, we should have no problems with accepting AB because they are not attacked. They are unattacked arguments, so we accept AB. Accepting AB entails rejecting C because C is attacked by A as well as B. So, and now on the next step, we are faced with a choice. So either D1 or D2. So let us assume that D1 means let's go to dance tonight, and D2, let's go in the theater tonight. So here we have the choice. And let's go dance. So we choose D1. And this entails that we have to reject D2 as well as E because they are attacked by D1. And finally, we have no problem with accepting F because it is unattacked, and accepting F yields to rejecting a G. So in this way, we can reconstruct the complete extension A, B, D1, and F. So let's jump back and let us assume that we go to the theater instead, that we decide to go to the theater, and in this situation, we reject D1 because it is attacked by D2, and now we cannot collect unattacked arguments in the remaining frameworks. And this explanation corresponds to AB D2, and the missing set AB simply corresponds to selecting nothing, so it means we stay at home. This is in a very informal way how to explain, how to understand complete extensions, but of course we have done this more formally with so-called explanation schemes. And an explanation scheme is a triple E0, E1, E2, such that E0 is the grounded extension of F. Yeah? The grounded extension, all arguments in the grounded extension can be traced back to unattacked arguments. So this is a very skeptical view. And in the second step, we do a conflict-free choice. This means we select arguments from even cycles of the reduct from F with respect to E0. This formalizes somehow the situation after accepting A0, because the reduct contains all arguments which are neither in E0 nor attacked by E0. And finally, E2 is again the grounded extension after accepting E1. And we call an explanation scheme successful if E0, E1, E2 defends E1. So please observe, important that an explanation scheme is uniquely determined by E1. So why is this the case? Because the grounded extension is uniquely determined, and the set E2 only depends on E1. Yeah? So the only choice somehow is here E1. And with this definition, we have a new characterization for complete semantics. Namely, a set is complete if and only if it can be decomposed into a successful explanation scheme. And yeah, with this characterization at hand, we defined a new notion of explanation. We say, given a successful explanation scheme, and if a set X is contained in the union of E0, E1, and E2, we say that E1 is an explanation, a scheme-based explanation for X. So let's come back to the example. So if somebody asks, so why we gradually accept F, we can say, okay, an explanation for F is the choice D1. So because this is the only thing which was non-deterministic here in this case with respect to complete semantics. So we also did some complexity analysis, for instance, verification is tractable because you only have to compute the grounded semantics as well as the reduct. And the existence problem boils down to the question whether there is a superset containing X, and this is NP complete. And at the end, excursus, we also considered admissible extensions, and we have a similar characterization theorem. You see it here at the bottom. A set is an admissible set or admissible extension if and only if it can be decomposed into a successful strong admissibility explanation scheme. And at the bottom here, you see the definition of a strong admissibility explanation scheme, and I will not go into the details, just as take-home message here, the role of grounded semantics with respect to complete semantics is played by strongly admissible sets in case of admissible extensions. Okay, so far for this, thank you very much. Thank you for your attention.